welcome back to another video. I hope you're all doing okay. Today I'm going to be doing a full set on a client again, so exciting times. Today this client has gone for some almond spring sort of set. I will save the surprise for the end, although you definitely want to see on the thumbnail, but anyway. So yeah, let's get into it.
So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go in with my cuticle bit on my e-file and neaten up the cuticles a little bit. This in particular client didn't have too much cuticle on there that needed removing, so I was just giving it a tidy up, just making sure that there was no sort of skin left on the nail bed that would cause any lifting or anything. I'm then going to do the same with the sanding band when I go in and etch the nail. So this is just to make sure that I remove all of the surface shine on the nail to make sure it's prepped properly for the application. So this is a 240 grit sanding band, and I always use these on the natural nails just so they're not as harsh. It's the lightest grit that we have. Once that's done, I'm just going to go in with my cuticle nippers and remove any excess cuticle. Like I say, there wasn't too much on this client, so I just sort of got off what I could see and didn't want to mess too much. Like I say, if there's nothing really on the nail bed, I pretty much just leave the cuticles alone. I just make sure that I run over the nail bed with this cuticle tool. It's just got a sort of like a sharp blade, and just to go over the around the cuticle area and make sure that there's no cuticle left on the nail bed. Thank you. So that's all my prep done. So I'm going to go in and just put on the tips now. I'm using the clear pinch square tips by Glitterbells. Even though this client's not going to keep them square, they are actually going to be almond, but I didn't have any other tips, so I can just shape them from these tips anyway. Now I'm just going to cut the tips down to the desired length. This client hasn't had nails for a while, so she wanted to keep them pretty short just to get used to having them again. And obviously they are going to be almond, so they will need shaping up afterwards. This is the technique that I use just to make sure that all of my clients' nails are the same length. So this is the technique that I use to achieve my almond shape. I just get the nail clippers and sort of go round in the almond sort of shape, and they don't have to be neat because obviously I'm going to be going in with my file anyway. File that I use is the 180 file by NSI, and I'm just going to go over them and give them a shape now and blend my tips in. Now that my tips are applied and shaped and blended, I'm just going to go in with my dehydrator and primer. These are also from NSI. So my nails are ready for acrylic application now. I'm using Pink Opal by Glitterbells and I'm using my size 10 brush from Glitterbells as well.
Thank you.
So there's all my acrylic applied. I've just changed the files that I'm using to a coarser grit, and I'm going to go around and give them another shape up after the application. Here I'm just going over them with the buffing block, which is also from Glitter Bells. Next, I just like to put a layer of top coat on before I go in with any gel polish on my tips. It's just how I like to work. It's not necessary, but I just find the application of the gel a lot easier. Thank you. So after that's cured for 60 seconds, I'm just going to go in with the different coloured tips that this client wanted. I'm using all of the gel bottle colours. This blue on the pinky is shade Tiffany. This purple is Flax. This yellow one is from the Pastel collection. On the index finger is Coral Touch. And on the thumb is the shade Michelle. All of these have been applied with the fine nail art brush from the Glitter Bells nail art collection. And after all that's done, I'm just going to top coat and cure for 60 seconds. Just apply some cuticle oil with my cuticle pen. And this is the finished look.
So there you go guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions or anything, just drop them in the comments below and I'll come back to you. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and thank you very much for watching. If you want to follow me on my other socials, it's @thenailroombyg on Instagram and TikTok, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.